My name's David Locke. I'm a Lieutenant Commander in the Sea Cadet Corps, and this is Willesden and Marylebone Sea Cadets TS Bicester. The Sea Cadets nationally are supported by the Royal Navy, but the Sea Cadets nationally is also a registered charity, so they also raise their own money. But locally, each Sea Cadet unit is also a registered charity. So this unit is its own registered charity and needs to raise its own funds to continue its work. So everything about the building and the training and the cadets needs to be raised locally. This building was taken over in 1947 from the YMCA and was first occupied as a Sea Cadet unit about 2 years later. So about 1949, the Sea Cadets have been in this building. All my friends from school were joining the Sea Cadets, although they were a little bit older than me. And me and my twin brother decided to join. It was an experience. I must admit, it was very daunting walking into this building with lots of people in full uniforms. But it was interesting, it was exciting, and it was completely different from what anything I'd ever done before. I suppose that was the attraction, there's the fact that the building does look like a ship when you walk in, and is very unusual in that respect. This gun is a 40mm Bofurs gun, and was acquired from the Royal Navy in about 1968, and was brought in piece by piece, and reconstructed inside the building. It's actually sitting on a concrete base that all the staff and the cadets had to fill up. I would say that 50% of what you're actually seeing when you walk through the door, because it looks like a ship, makes the ethos of the Sea Cadets that much more better. If you're walking into just a hut or something, you're not getting that feeling of walking into a ship, where here, you get the feeling the moment you walk through the door that you're part of the Royal Navy or part of the Sea Cadet Corps, and that helps. That really helps the cadets feel part of something important. The name Bicester is taken from the Bicester Hunt, you know, because ships were named after a certain class, or class of ship was Hunt class destroyers, and they all took the names of different hunts across the country, and we took Bicester back in the 60s. Right, this is the bridge of TS Bicester. It is purely for show. It's there, the bridge is the control centre for the ship. So that's why you'd have a ship's wheel. You'd have the engine telegraphs, which are these things here, which produce the speed, which would ring down to the engine room. And obviously the voice pipes down to the various compartments. And over there, you'd have a compass, so you know that you're going to be heading in the right direction. Here we've got a mast where you've got the lights on it, a radar, and you'd be pulling up your various flags so that people know what the times are, what's going on, and a chart work table, so you'd have your charts, and you could work out whereabouts you would be if you was actually steaming. We do hold mini exercises up here so that we pretend, if you like, that we're going through a channel, and we can then pretend that we're actually working a chart, so people have a rough idea of what's going on and what they would see if they're actually doing it for real. Training on an environment like this will help them when they do actually go aboard ships, the ships that the Sea Cadet Corps actually own, so they have an understanding before they go on the ship what they're actually going to experience and how it's going to work. Yeah. Although it's obviously a little more modern than this stuff, the same principles apply. Pointy flags are called pennants, and they're awarded each year that the unit, each Sea Cadet unit, reaches a certain standard. So if you're a good standard, you get a pennant, and if you're a really good standard, very high standard, you get a burgee, which is the other ones with a little dovetail on. This is only a small minority of the flags that the unit's got over the years. But this unit was also the best Sea Cadet unit in London in 1964. This bosun store has been refurbished in the last few years. It was a lot, believe it or not, it was a lot darker than what it used to be. But effectively, the equipment hasn't changed. It's still the same sort of equipment. Obviously, ropes get renewed every now and then. But effectively, the same amount of kit is in here that when I first joined the Sea Cadets. Right, these are just training aids. These are here purely to show cadets the different types of sails that you'd have on a ship, different ways that ships are laid out, So whether it be that one or the different types of hooks you've got that you can find on ships. So there's lots of different variations for a theme. You can just look around in here. You can see that we've got very small blocks and very large blocks. Yeah, so it's just a matter of having the various sizes to show cadets the different sort of sizes you're going to get on a ship. Because obviously a small sailing dinghy is going to have smaller blocks than if you're going to be working on something like an aircraft carrier. This sort of block here would be used on something called a davit, effectively, which is a something that you could use to pull on a bigger ship. You pull your smaller boat up and down off onto the water and then on back onto the deck. So you'd be using something on those sides. And in fact, originally we had two of those, or four of those, out on the deck. We used to pull the boat up on up into the ceiling and then back down again. Bosun store and all the equipment we've got in here is relevant to Sea Cadets because we go boating. Yeah, so anything you do with boats involves pieces of rope. Yeah, and if you pull the wrong piece of rope, the boat will go over and you'll get wet. Yeah, and you've got to know what pieces of rope to pull and when. You also need to know that we have a seamanship syllabus, so we teach cadets very basic seamanship, right to through very complicated seamanship. So we'd start off with very basic knots, reef knots, clove hitches, and then we teach cadets how to make something like this. But ultimately, it's all to do with the work that we do on boats, whether it be a dinghy or a ship. Yeah, ultimately, you need to know what you're doing with ropes because they can be dangerous. By my window on a cold and cloudy day.
My first impression when I first stepped into this building was of total awe and surprise. Nothing had prepared me for how extraordinary it is. I don't think there's anything else like it anywhere in Britain. And I've become very involved on the committee for the conservation and restoration of the building, as Sea Cadets have so much to do working to ensure that the life of Sea Cadets goes on. And we have great plans for the future for the next, we hope, 150 years of this building, and that it is a living museum, but that also it's also a community centre and puts on events, and people are welcome to originate their own events. We have people wanting to do things like a 1940s fashion show, people doing music, choirs, dance, theatre. The future of this building will go on.
I love this building. I think this building's great. It's taken thousands of man hours to get it where it is, and it's still going to take thousands of man hours to bring it back up to scratch. But it's not just about the building, it's about the cadets that you've had here as well. I mean, I've had, you know, hundreds of cadets come through the system here. You know, that not all of them have made it great, but I like to think that most of them have gone away with a sense of pride and a sense of achievement. And ultimately, that's what we're here for. We're keeping kids off the street. You know, we're not here to, we're not here as a recruiting vehicle for the Royal Navy or the Army or the Air Force. We're here to just make good cadets, good citizens. And I think generally speaking, we do a pretty good job.